Hello, everybody. It is October 12th, 2020, and I'm just making this little video of basically representing everything that I've been growing in my garden and a couple of things that I haven't tasted yet. This is a Bahamian goat, and this is a Taj Mahal Pink Minion, and I'm gonna cut this one open and taste it because I'm not sure what it is or how it's gonna taste. And this is a Taj Mahal Pink Minion. I know what it is. I don't know how it's gonna taste. So I might cut this one open in this video, depending on if I could still taste anything after this. Anyways, I just wanted to show you the things that I've been growing. This is a sugar rush peach pepper. And we'll cut everything open. Let's see if I can get my hand in here. Turn the knife the correct cutting way. I grew this one indoors under actually only 32 watts. And like, I've got a huge indoor garden, and I'm very impressed at these GE lights. I made a review on it earlier. So that's the sugar rush peach. I'd say it's about as hot as a habanero. Has a little bit more fleshy of like the pepper is more like a bell pepper in consistency than a jalapeno. It's maybe more crunchy. It tastes really fresh. It's a great pepper. I'm really happy I got that. Thank you to the person who sent it to me. What else should we do? This is a chocolate Trinidad scorpion. I picked the sugar, all the peppers fresh today, and the carrots. I'm just gonna cut all these open so you can see what they look like on the inside, just for comparison. Hopefully none of them are full of mold. Oh man, I can smell that. This chocolate Trinidad scorpion is really strong. This is probably the hottest pepper on the table. Unless this one is, and I don't know. I just want to cut that one open and show you. This is a Tabasco. This plant has been super prolific. And if you just want to choose one pepper plant to grow on your balcony, you can grow one of these Tabascos and it will suffice a person with a spicy palate. It's prolific enough and it does its job and it tastes great. I would eat a little piece of it right now, but I don't want to spoil my palate for tasting this other one. The spice of the sugar rush peach is already gone. We're gonna save this one. This is an alpine strawberry sitting on top of a quarter. That's what's going on with this. And if you haven't grown an alpine strawberry, you should look into that. Because these things are awesome. These are just some short and sweet Bonnie carrots. They're really tiny. I don't really recommend them at all just because they're so small. These are just some cherry tomatoes that I forget where I got the seeds. I grew this from seed though. I think I got the seeds from Home Depot. It's just like their cheap cherry tomato seeds. And I don't know, I'm not a very good tomato farmer. They always come out mostly sour. I don't have it bright enough. I don't. Lately, I've been, I gave it some Epsom salt. I don't know if you can see it. I gave these plants some Epsom salt. So hopefully, I don't know, it did make a difference. I do think it made them a little bit sweeter, but I think it's just like the alkali in my soil or. There's something in my soil that makes tomatoes sour. So, I have a lot to learn. If you have any pointers, go ahead and leave a comment. That would be awesome. And now, the king of the show. This is supposed to be a Bahamian goat. From what I can see of the pictures online, they don't have this pointy bottom. So I'm not exactly sure what this is. I don't know. It's orange. It's pepper. It grew pretty good. Looking, it doesn't have a super strong smell like that. Oh, excuse me, the chocolate Trinidad scorpion. It's got plenty of seeds. Definitely save some of those. I'll be a little brave and I'll eat this whole piece right here. Or should I be conservative so we can taste this one? I don't know. From the way this smells, it doesn't smell hotter than a habanero. So I should still be able to taste it. If I ate that chocolate Trinidad, if I eat this big of a piece of that chocolate Trinidad scorpion, I'd die. Like, for 5 minutes, I'd be like snorting like saliva and snot and stuff like that. But I think I'll be all right eating this. Let's find out. It definitely has a habanero fruity smell, like the chocolate Trinidad scorpion. It mostly smells just like a habanero to me, actually. I thought it was going to be way hotter. Let's find out. It definitely has a very strong fruity smell taste. As soon as I bit into that, I thought I was in huge trouble. His instant flavor, he takes a second. Still building. Definitely had the strong pepper fruity taste. No floral. It's a little hotter than I thought it was gonna be. I don't know. Let's cut this one open anyways. I don't know if I'll be able to taste it. I definitely want to save these seeds. So I'm going to be careful if I can. Ooh, it is thick. Oh, wow. That is not what I expected. It has, like, white flesh, and it's thick. You can see the capsaicin along the inner walls. I don't know if I'll be able to describe this very good because I just ate that other one. Let's see what happens. What does it smell like? I can tell it's pretty strong. It doesn't have the same fruitiness as this one. Let's try it. Oh, wow, that's way different. It's hotter. Wow. Wow. So, it has a much more like plant-based taste. It tastes more like I ate a leaf or something. It is a different heat. Wow. It's making me sweat. It's not making me drool like this other one. It's pretty interesting. And let's eat the little strawberry. Seriously, if you haven't heard of an alpine strawberry, you should Google it and find somewhere to get some seeds. Because these are really, really good. Oh, it even busts through all that pepper. It tastes like you ate like five strawberries at once, and then somebody like condensed all the flavor into one little teeny strawberry. Ooh, yeah. Okay. Let's just eat a little bit of everything now. It's my carrot. It is sweeter than a regular carrot you get from the store. Tastes just like it otherwise, though. Anything else? Oh, you got my tomato. So yep, it's a tomato. That one was actually pretty sweet. Alright, everybody. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you again for more garden videos throughout the winter and for next year too. Thanks very much for watching.